سعيد أن أقف أمامكم to talk about one of the most important cardiac disease. It is the acute traumatic fevers and rheumatic heart disease. I'm Nuruddin Al-Jaber, Associated Professor of Cardiology at Sana'a University. When we are going to talk about rheumatic heart disease, how to diagnose and how to manage, we should go through the World Heart Federation's and the WHO and Cardiac Society's guidelines to use them in our talk. I'm going to talk about this topic from this agenda. I give you the brief introductions, some acute traumatic fevers, cardiac affections, and definitions of rheumatic heart disease, signs and symptoms of rheumatic heart disease, and the investigations could be done, how to prophylax such disease, and what are the management available. So rheumatic heart disease is the result of damage of the cardiac valves, which occur due to repeated episodes of acute traumatic fevers. Early diagnosis and treatment of rheumatic heart disease, it is important in prognosis of disease and in management of such disease sequelae. The signs and symptoms of such a disease, they are not start early, they may start after years, and I am of management of early management of the such a disease to prevent delayed complications and may need of valvular surgery. So rheumatic heart disease could be prevented if acute rheumatic fever is diagnosed and managed early. Around 50% of people with rheumatic heart disease do not remember they have acute rheumatic fever. So it may be you cannot clear to say this goes after sore throat or anything. So the acute traumatic fevers, the sequelae and the dilemma of that such disease is occur when there is a susceptible host and he had a recurrent attack of streptococcal infections ending by acute traumatic fevers by many things. There is something helping that, like environmental factors like overcrowding, and there is precipitating event like more repeated infections by streptococcal infections. And there is also immunity affections and genetic factors affections. That's acute rheumatic fever leading to rheumatic heart disease. Either it is in one single episode or recurrent episodes of acute rheumatic fevers. So starting from sore throat, and then it goes to affect the patient's heart, and usually they get the joints simply, and they just what we call lacks the joint and by the heart. So the dilemma or the disease manifestation of acute traumatic fevers could be affect the heart by valvular affections or pericarditis or myocarditis. It may lead to erythema marginatum, subcutaneous nodule, arthritis or arthralgia, rheumatic or Sydenham, chorea, and there is other biochemical markers that they may raise like ESO titers. To diagnose rheumatic fevers, this you should follow the what we call the medical model or medical triangle, starting from the history, examine the investigation using the Jones criteria or modified Jones criteria to diagnose such disease, and then you will use what we call the pre-test probability to help you in diagnosis of rheumatic heart disease by using echocardiography. These pre-test probabilities, they are varies according to geographical locations, like that the people they have rainy areas, ethnicity, like the people they have higher endemicity of such a disease, and the poverty, people living in poor conditions. So rheumatic heart disease after attack of acute rheumatic fevers, it may comes from 5 to 15 years, the most susceptible age, and it is rare below 3. The girls is more affected than the boys. They are common in the third world countries, and there is what we call the environmental factor, like overcrowding, poor sanitation, poverty, job like overcrowded, like nurses, and so on. The incidence more during fall of winters and early spring. So rheumatic heart disease, it is permanent valvular affections due to recurrent attacks of acute traumatic. Nearly 40 to 60% of patients with acute rheumatic fevers, they develop rheumatic heart disease. And about 2 to 10 years, they need after acute rheumatic fevers affections to distract the valves or at least valve destructions. So Yemen, it is located here, and the percent of development or the prevalence of rheumatic heart disease in our country around 1.8 case per 1,000 cases. So the definitions of valvular affections in rheumatic heart disease, it may lead to valvular regurg or valvular stenosis. Valvular regurg, it is in echo, you can see them as sticky against the wall of the heart and do not meet each other, so they are becoming open, and so that's why they cannot close the valve properly, leading to backward flow of the blood, or we call regurg. Stenosis, when it's occur, when the valve is becoming stick and they are closed like that, they cannot open nicely, so that's why the blood, it will not go through these stenotic valves. So this is just an example. If you see this morphis, this is the valve, the mitral valve, it looks to be a thickened, doming, stick valve. It's not open nicely, and there is also smoky flow. You see it in the left atrium. This is typical features of rheumatic heart disease affecting mitral valve in the form of mitral or severe mitral valve stenosis. So the sign of symptoms of rheumatic heart disease, they will not come easily and early. So in early cases of the disease or mild to moderate disease, they will not find any symptoms sometimes. And the symptoms suggest moderate to severe disease. So what are these symptoms? Shortness of breath, there is easy fatigue, and you are feeling tiredness, general weakness, peripheral edema, paroxysmal nocturnal dyspnea, and so on. So that's why they made what we call these like iceberg triangle. So this, you see just only the things which is symptomatic, active rheumatic disease, you may find that they are close to death, or they are requiring surgery, or they are causing the sequelae of rheumatic like thromboembolic phenomena or endocarditis, or they may come with heart failure. But those people who are asymptomatic rheumatic, or what we call latent disease in mild to moderate form, usually in the clinical practice, we are not finding them unless we are taking care or with other clinical data. So the heart valve affections are involved. Usually the mitral valve is the most affected valve, and then followed by aortic valve, then the tricuspid and the pulmonary valve. If you see from this drawing, the mitral valve only, it makes around 30% affected. So it may be involved with other valvular diseases, but it is the dominant valve. It may be affected, started in a case of regurg, and then stenosis to progressive disease, especially in adult, and they may come with complications like atrial fibrillations. Then the second valve is affected, the aortic, which become an aortic regurg, usually in associations with rheumatic valve affections, and they may present with sequelae of aortic regurg. Then it will affect the tricuspid and pulmonary valves. They said that streptococcus is there, leading to acute rheumatic fevers, then rheumatic heart disease. The valves affected usually mitral, then aortic, tricuspid, they call it ILAF NAD. So this is the mitral and then aortic valve, tricuspid, then the pulmonary valves affections. And this is the percentage clear how much is the mitral is affected. So the clinical examinations data on the precordium, you can find mitral regurg, systolic murmur in the apex, radiate to the axilla, mitral stenosis, mid-diastolic rumbling murmurs, aortic regurg in hollow diastolic blowing murmurs, aortic stenosis, and here loud pitching mid-systolic ejection murmurs. How to investigate rheumatic heart disease? So you'll do blood and serology, CBC and ASO, ECG, and then chest X-ray. You may need it to determine the cardiac size, especially in moderate to severe form, and then the echocardiography to identify the heart valve damage, to estimate the severity of valve, which is useful for follow-up of these patients and determining of what's in need, medical or surgical treatment. Prophylaxis and management of rheumatic heart disease, the key points of, or the key elements in rheumatic heart management, so start by secondary prophylaxis. The function of this secondary prophylaxis in established rheumatic heart disease, it is prevent group A streptococcal infections. So it's prevent repeated development of acute rheumatic fever, prevent the development of rheumatic heart disease or severe form, and reduce the severity of disease and help to reduce the risk of death from severe rheumatic heart disease. How we are doing? By long-acting penicillin or alternative antibiotics if there is allergy to the penicillin. The idea that by penicillin injections we have a good heart. So when the rheumatic heart disease involves the heart, what we are going to do? First, do what we call effective baseline assessment, educations, and refiller of the patients. Meaning, start the initial management. If the patient's coming with heart failure, it should be treated in the heart failure management. If there is atrial fibrillations, treated as atrial fibrillations by digoxin or anticoagulant. Then do what we call routine review and structural care planning, like regular secondary prophylaxis, regular clinical assessment on the floor using the echocardiography, and then do what we call dental care for a patient to inhibit or to prevent occurrence of endocarditis, do family planning for a woman, and then vaccinations if need. Any appropriate patients, he needs surgical interventions, so we should refer him for surgical interventions. Special considerations should be taken there, especially in pregnant ladies. So in pregnancy, you know, the heart is working a lot. So it's increased the heart rate, the blood volume, it is the systemic and pulmonary resistance, it became low, and there is increase in heart. Well, this is an overload of the patient. On top of rheumatic heart disease, the load, it will be more and more. So even so, the early diagnosis of rheumatic, it could be found during pregnancy. The high risk of complications usually occur immediately or during delivery, because you may get endocarditis if they are not managed nicely. So in pregnancy, you should treat them properly and proper follow-up. A special concern should be taken if there is severe stenotic valve, atrial fibrillations, prosthetic valve, or patient is receiving anticoagulant during pregnancy. If the patient's caring that we are afraid to get infective endocarditis in case of rheumatic, so it is a serious complications, so it is because of bacterial, they get a nice place to be infiltrate the cardiac tissue, especially the endocardium, so we should treat them nicely, and we should do what we call the dental care during surgical procedures, and may use prophylaxis endocarditis immediately after an intervention, especially that patients who have a cardiac surgery, antibiotic prior to any interventions they may need if there is a valvular damage. So all people with acute rheumatic fevers and rheumatic heart disease should have regular dental care to prevent dental decay and potential risk of endocarditis. There are many procedures that we are going to use endocarditis on them, but what I can say, so if there is any blood is coming or in contact to the blood, then the bacteremia, it may happen. So any case, any interventions leading to blood contact, so exposures of the blood, so it's better to give an antibiotics as a prophylaxis. The need of surgery, or it is the delay form, or the last form of management of case of rheumatic heart disease, it depends on the severity of symptoms, evidence of severely damaged valve, if there is left ventricle size is large, and there is availability of long-term management of after surgery. So which heart valves could be either repaired or replaced? So assessment of surgery, we should include all the clinical data beside the echocardiographic assessment, then we do dental care, then we review all the management prior to the surgical interventions or any other co-diseases that occur in such patients of rheumatic heart disease. There is a balance between heart valve repair or replacement. So which one is better or no? So repair we are doing usually in susceptible patients, especially rheumatic repair, it is a little bit difficult, but we need no anticoagulant, but it may stay for a short time and you need surgery back again. And the valve replacement, it is better, but the problem that we need anticoagulant required for life or longer durations of such interventions. The second question is coming to the mind, which valve I'm going to do, either it is tissue valve or metallic valve. It depends on two factors in the tissue valve: durability and hemodynamic effections. And valve is metallic, so we are afraid of bleeding and thromboembolic complications. So if we just divide the rheumatic heart disease into mild, moderate, and severe form, how we can manage them? So the mild one, what you call it, is mild rheumatic, there is trivial or mild valve disease or lesions. So we should know secondary, should do secondary prophylaxis, primary management, care management by local officers, a specialist medical review of children aged than 18 years every 12 months, or earlier if the clinical deteriorations occur, we need to use the echocardiography at least in 2 years or even in 5 years if the disease is low, and this special medical review before cessations of secondary prophylaxis, dental review following the diagnosis. In moderate form of disease, what we define moderate form of disease, we define it that there is a moderate valve affections, there is no symptoms, and left ventricle functions with stable, with other, or the patient with a stable metallic prosthesis valve, our children aged to 18 years old with a history of chorea, including those with no valve damage. So all of these people, we consider them that moderate form of rheumatic heart disease. What we are going to do for such patients? So such patients, we should do secondary prophylaxis by long-acting penicillin, primary management by the local officer, special medical concerns every 2 years, every 1 year. That means we should follow them up, echocardiography every 1 year, or you may need it after 2 years if it's adult and they have no recurrent sore throat affections or no recurrent symptoms, and we should go proper medical review and using the secondary prophylaxis, and again the dental review for following after following the diagnosis with appropriate endocarditis preventions. In severe form, what we means by severe form of rheumatic heart disease, so it is any moderate or severe valve lesions with shortness of breath, tiredness, edema, angina, or syncope, and impaired or increased left ventricle functions, or a history of valve surgery, including mitral valvotomy, any valve repair with bioprosthetic valve, like a Brocken valve, on hemograph, all of these people considered to be a severe form of rheumatic heart disease. What we should do for them? We should do secondary prophylaxis by long-term preventions of recurrent acute rheumatic fevers, primary care management by local officer, a specialist medical review every 6 months, refer for a heart specialist if there is another plan or need more intensive plan management like surgery or anything. So in summary, we can say to you that rheumatic heart disease present as a damage of the heart valve after exposures of acute rheumatic fevers. The mitral valve is the most valve afflictions. Rheumatic heart disease could be mild, moderate, or severe. Rheumatic heart may be symptomatic. So the management of rheumatic heart includes treatment of the cardiac and other symptoms, long-term secondary prophylaxis, regular medical and cardiac review, management of existing conditions like pregnancy, dental assessment, and family planning, it should be there. Thank you for watching and listening. وألقاكم إن شاء الله في لقاء علمي آخر. دمتم بخير والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله.